Hey, horse people! Alright, we're going to talk about saddle pads and saddle fit. But I just did a video on how to connect the cinch, and I forgot to show you where Smokey's in here sleeping. Sorry, Smokey, I just saw a YouTuber, you're in here sleeping while Dad's filming. You can stay there. I woke him up. So anyway, he's been in here just sleeping with his dad or filming with his dad. Okay, so let's talk about saddle pad and which is better and which is worse, and just overall to get an idea on saddle widths and pads. So what I have here is I have three saddle pads. Top one's not as thick as the second one. The first one is thicker than the second one, and I have three saddle pads and a blanket. So, when putting saddle pads on, so we have a blanket, I have a saddle pad, I have a second saddle pad, and I have a third saddle pad. So, which one is, forgot to spin my little thingy around, which one's better, and if one is good, why wouldn't two be better? Why would three be better? And then three with a blanket, that's even better. And then maybe I have this little piece of plastic rubber here, and I'll put that there to make my horse really feel comfortable and soft. Isn't that good, Rick? I have all this between my horse and saddle. No, it's not good. So, less is more in horsemanship. This blanket is a little thin for me just to be riding on a blanket. I would not ride my horse with just this blanket. I don't think it's thick enough. So I would not use just this blanket. This pad is a very old pad. I pulled out of a trash can that somebody threw away because it was tacky. Smokey uses it as a sleep blanket. I lay it down on the floor when I need to kneel on something. It's like a kneeling pad for me if I'm working on something. But it's kind of, it's got something inside. This is very loose here, and then it has another little pad inside. So it's not a good solid blanket. Had a little bit of leather here, it looked cool. Had a little bit of leather here, that looked cool. You notice it's straight, not like a horse's back, which is curved. A horse's back goes down like this. A lot of blankets are like this. I don't like straight blankets. I like blankets that are curved, like a horse's back, curved, okay? This horse has a nice seam in the middle, so it meets on the horse and lays more natural on the horse. This one, even though it's old, doesn't lean very natural. See how it kind of sticks out there? Versus this one that kind of like falls on the horse more, it's going to fit the horse better. Now, these pads are wool. I think this might be a 3/4 inch, and this one might be a 1 inch. These are pretty expensive. This also has a shoulder cutout. I think it's very important. This is where the horse's withers comes up. Usually that's the highest part of the horse. If this cutout isn't here, it just puts pressure on that on top of the saddle. And then this one also has a little cutout here. It also has the centerpiece that's cut, and it also lays and fits better on the horse. So I'm not really doing a saddle pad advertisement here. I'm more doing what's correct. So let's take a look at this saddle over here. Zoom in on that. So when the saddle is on the horse, if this was a horse, his withers were here, it's always a little higher. That's why horses have this. It kind of fits right here. Leaves room for the withers. This right here sets on a horse. A lot of people say, how do you know if a saddle fits a horse? To me, one of the best ways to tell if your saddle fits a horse is put the saddle on a horse with nothing, just like it is. Put it on there and then try to move it side to side. Does it fall over? If it falls off and slides over, probably doesn't fit the horse that well. If it kind of sits where you put it and it's pretty solid,
then it probably fits a horse. Now, that's not the only way. You can get hot spots. If I reach under here, there's no contact here because the horse has shoulders here, and there's contact here. When you're looking to see for saddle fit, you want to look for dry spots on a horse when you take the saddle off. If there is a dry spot, that means there's been so much pressure at one point that the horse couldn't even sweat there and the hair is dry. So it's sweat all around where the pressure is. So normally a dry spot on a horse when you take the saddle and pad off is an indicator of a pressure point that your saddle is putting too much pressure on a horse. He can't even sweat. There's so much pressure. If he's uniform sweating when you take it off, you're probably good to go. So this is on the horse pretty good. Do I want more than one saddle pad?
Depends. Depends on how thick your saddle pad is. I don't think you want to go over
an inch on a saddle pad. So if you have two saddle pads, oh shit, that didn't go over well. If you have two saddle, we're okay. Whatever. So if you have two saddle pads here, you start getting too thick. So this is to simulate kind of like the horse. Obviously, it's not this high, but it fits on a horse's back. Now, if I put this saddle,
I just forget to turn this when I come over here and do this.
If I put this saddle on this one, how are we going to do this? It's going to be a pain in the butt. I have one saddle pad. So the saddle still stays on a horse. The saddle pad stays on a horse. Really key when you put saddle pads, always, always, I can always tell a good horse person, when they shove this saddle pad up into this gullet. Because as you ride, this tends to flatten out. Damn, everything's falling off the saddle. And it tends to flatten out and put more pressure on a horse's right here at his neck, because his neck comes up here. So always when you saddle a horse, get your saddle pad as high up in this gullet, so this. And you should almost be able to put your hand in between this and the horse, and you know your saddle pad. I see people riding, and their damn saddle pad is so tight, and there's this big gap here above the saddle pad. Meanwhile, the saddle pad is scrunching and pushing on the horse's neck. Every time he lifts his neck, it's just really tight. So always pull the saddle pad up. So one saddle pad, I think this is fine. What happens when you put more than one saddle pad? Well, let's put two and see what happens. So two must be better than one because it's more cushion, right? No. What happens when you get too much in here, you create this roundness and the saddle doesn't want to stay on the horse. And it rides on top of the horse. So now, instead of sitting on the horse, like I said, when you put it on before, the cinch is the only thing that's holding it on the horse. So it puts more pressure on the cinch, and it also allows you to more likely to slide when you start getting too high. It raises your center of gravity from the horse. The closer you are to the horse, the better. You've already got a saddle in between you and the horse. Now you've got one pad in between. You've got people that want to put a second pad. Because it helps the horse, because two must be better. Well, if two's better, then why don't we put three? And a blanket, because it looks pretty. There. Now that's really good, Rick. I should put, fill that cushion. I can't even fill the horse. There's so many blankets in here. You've created a dome on top of the horse. So your saddle now doesn't, even if it fit before, it doesn't fit now. So too many pads is almost as bad as not enough. If I had my choice, I'd probably say too many is better than not enough. But it's almost as bad. So now with three blankets and a saddle, I've got this saddle, or three blankets and a saddle pad, or a saddle blanket and three pads. Now this saddle is just like floating on top. And now you're sitting on a saddle floating on top of the three blankets and the blanket, the three saddle pads, and a saddle. So, what's the best saddle pad? What's the best length? Should I put one, two? You know, look, you're going to get 1,000 people telling you
what you should and shouldn't do. I'm giving you my opinion from my experience. One pad is sufficient if it's thick enough. If you have two pads that can make 3/4 of an inch, then I'd say two pads. If you go over 3/4 or an inch, I think you're getting too thick. I think an inch is probably the max. I buy inch because, you know, I'm pushing 200 pounds, and 200 pounds plus my saddle, which is 50 pounds, it mashes down a 1-inch pad to a 3/4-inch pad. If you're lighter, you're probably not going to mash down a 1-inch pad. So 3/4 to 1-inch pad is good. It's sufficient. If you're using a blanket on top of your pad, then you might want to get a little bit thinner pad, because that blanket's going to add height, thickness, and roundness to your horse, and it's going to take away the ability for the saddle to fit the horse, for the saddle to stay stable on the horse without relying on the cinch that you have to cinch down 2 knots tighter because your saddle is rolling off if you don't. Because when you get on, the saddle slides to one side or the other because you've got so many pads that you've just made a big round thing that's, you know, rolling around on a horse. So that's my spiel on saddle pads. Did I answer your question? Look, I'm not here to say you need to do this. This is what I do, and my way is the right way, and it's the only way. I'm just here to tell you, when you make a decision, have an educated decision, figure it out, understand how a saddle is supposed to fit. Throw your saddle on a horse with no blanket and see if it sits on him. If you take away that ability for your saddle to stay on a horse without a blanket by putting too many blankets, then you've got too many. I would never put a saddle on a horse without a blanket. I think absolutely you need some sort of barrier. I wouldn't ride a horse with just that little wool blanket and not a saddle pad. I'm saying blanket for saddle pad, but basically don't ride a horse without a saddle pad. And don't ride a horse with just a horse blanket. You want to put a blanket over a saddle pad? Great. Don't have a really, really thick blanket, and don't have a really, really thick saddle pad, because now you've doubled the thickness. That's my opinion. Take it for what it's worth. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys. Where's the hell that crazy cat? And Moki.
You're a good kitty too. Say hello to YouTubies. Meow, 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 meow.
Shut up, Dad. I'm trying to sleep. All right, we'll end that there.